One of the first women to accuse Alabama Senate nominee Roy Moore of inappropriately touching her when she was only 14 just spoke out in her first TV interview. Her name is Lee Korfman, and she describes in detail what she says happened when she met with Moore, accusing him of preying on her. CNN's Caitlin Collins is live in Gadsden, Alabama with Moore. What do we learn?
Well, Chris, Lee Korfman is really the woman who opened the floodgates of these accusations against Roy Moore when she came out with her story about him in an interview with the Washington Post. Now, she was only 14 years old when she was at a courthouse here in Gadsden, Alabama, where Roy Moore is from, when a man who was in his 30s approached her and her mother and offered to watch her while her mother went inside for a custody hearing. Now, of course, that man was Roy Moore, and he got Korfman's number and later took her to his house. And here's what she said happened from there, Chris.
On the second occasion that I went with him, he basically laid out some blankets on the floor of his living room and proceeded to seduce me, I guess you would say. And during the course of that, he removed my clothing. He left the room and came back in wearing his white underwear. And he touched me over my clothing, what was left of it. And he tried to get me to touch him as well. And at that point, I pulled back and said that I was not comfortable. And I got dressed and he took me home. But I was a 14-year-old child trying to play in an adult's world, and he was 32 years old. It took years for me to regain a sense of confidence in myself, and I felt guilty. You know, I felt like I was the one that was to blame, and it was decades before I was able to let that go.
Now, Roy Moore has denied these allegations and said it's all part of a conspiracy between the media and the Republican establishment to derail his campaign. But Lee Korfman said this morning she was not paid to make these accusations against Moore. And in fact, she's voted Republican for years. But for her, this isn't political, she said. It's personal. Chris and Allison.
Caitlin, thank you very much. So, listen, it's always more powerful to hear from the person. We've read her accounts. We know the story. But to hear from her, herself, and what happened, that does feel different. To hear those details, suddenly, I don't know, it does feel really more intense and graphic.
And it matters more than usual because, ordinarily, if there's going to be a trial, if we hear from one side, all right, that's good, or both sides, that's good, but it's not about just us and them. It's about a jury, it's about a judge, it's about a prosecution and a defense. Not here. For people saying, well, he's guilty, he's innocent until proven guilty. That's true, but only in that context. This is the court of public opinion. This is only going to be about what you think about what she said, how it is offset by what he's able to offer up, like that he was assigned to her divorce case, it didn't come up sooner, those kinds of things, his denials. And then you get to make a decision, the lawmakers make a decision, the Alabama voters make a decision. This is the only process we'll have.
Yeah, it's really interesting to hear the rest of her interview as well. She says that she did consider many times going more public in a more national way, but she did tell friends and family at the time.
There is corroboration with most of these accounts. You have to read the Washington Post reporting and the reporting that's come afterwards. Too many people are having opinions without doing that.
There you go. Meanwhile, President Trump calls on